Welcome to another laptop media review. There is no better gaming than holiday gaming. The night is calm, the server's free, and all the flamers are forced to sit down on the table with their parents, while we hardcore gamers did not even think of budging away from our gaming stations. Before us, we have the Asus ROG Strix GL502VS, the GTX 1070 edition. In ancient Rome, in Greek legends, the Strix was a bird of ill omen that feasted with the flesh and blood of toxic League of Legends players. So hardcore. The design is fit for the premium gaming notebook niche. The casing is black with a brushed aluminum lid along with an LED illuminated ROG logo accompanied by two stripes in the middle. The bottom piece is made of black plastic and serves a big vent opening for extra airflow. A nice touch are the orange silicone legs that match the accent color of the device. The sides have grown a little bit, from 25 to 30 mm because of the GTX 1070, but as you can see, all the connectors are smartly distributed for an uncluttered gaming and working experience. The interior is made of plastic, which will reduce the spread of heat along the keyboard. The layout is familiar, comfortable, and orange. The GL502VS has two RAM slots, each supporting up to 16 GB of DDR4. It is equipped with a 2.5-inch hard drive slot, as well as an M.2 SSD slot and NVMe support. Our unit was shipped with an M.2 SATA SanDisk SSD, so be careful when buying your GL502. Make sure you order the variant with an NVMe-enabled drive if you want maximum storage performance. Asus has supplied the notebook with an excellent IPS panel, with numerous good properties making it fit for multimedia and gaming. We've got high maximum brightness of 324 nits, which is more than optimal for indoor and outdoor use. We develop unique profiles tailored for each individual display model, and we'll show you just how easy it is to install and use them. Firstly, for working with Photoshop, CorelDRAW, or just overall usage of the laptop, we'd recommend you the Office Work Web Design Profile that will maximize the GL502VS's color accuracy. You can see main and additional colors inside the sRGB gamut pre and post calibration. You will notice that before calibration, the dark areas of an image will appear dimmer or the light becomes even lighter. By applying the profile, you see that the gamma settings become almost perfect. We tested the accuracy of the display with 24 commonly used colors. You can check out the results at factory conditions and also with the Office Work Web Design Profile. The next figure shows how well the display is able to reproduce really dark parts of an image, which is essential when watching movies or playing games in low ambient light. The left side of the image represents the display with stock settings, while the right one is the one with the gaming and movie nights profile activated. You can easily check for yourself how your display handles the darkest nuances. One of the most important tests for gaming is the display's response time. We recorded fall time plus rise time of 27 milliseconds. This is normal for a notebook with an IPS panel, it is fast enough and there is a low probability that even a hardcore gamer will be able to spot any ghosting. Unfortunately, the PWM is still present even in this new version of the panel. It might not affect every user as the frequency of the emitted light is higher than usual, 21.2 kHz. Installing OVA HealthGuard profile not only eliminates PWM, but also reduces the harmful blue light emissions while keeping the colors of the screen perceptually accurate. If you are not familiar with the harm from blue light emissions, you can learn more about it in our specialized article that we will link in the top right corner of this video. The 64 watt-hour battery delivers a subpar performance. For average use in web browsing, it withstands for around 3 hours and 43 minutes. We doubt that you will game without a charger, but out of the system you get around 1 hour and 18 minutes of playtime. The Intel Core i7-6700HQ CPU is suitable for heavy applications and gaming. We compared the GL502VS with other notebooks with the same CPU. You can check the full tests and review in the Laptop Media website. To properly test the Nvidia GeForce GTX 1070, we pumped some games on Ultra and gave it a go. During the extensive temperature test, the CPU reached temperatures as high as 97 degrees Celsius, while the GPU at full load was pretty hot at 86 degrees Celsius. Our final summation is that with the Asus ROG GL502VS, you get an excellent G-Sync enabled IPS panel, cool looking design, the almighty GTX 1070 GPU on board but somehow with a lower performance, and a M2 PCIe NVMe storage support. The bottom line is that the Asus ROG GL502VS is a good 15-inch powerhouse with compelling features, but despite its relatively low price, it's hard to recommend it over the new Predator 15, which excels in all areas where this ROG fails. You can find the price and full review of the laptop in the description below. Thank you for watching Laptop Media. We have many more reviews waiting for you in our channel. Also consider subscribing so you'll always be up to date with the latest laptops, desktops, VR technologies, phones and everything our technological future will provide us. For more extensive information about this model and many more, visit laptopmedia.com.